We are back for another beautiful Saturday with some amazing women who are sharing their journey. Our next guest is Sierra Leone Princess, author, humanitarian, speaker, and she's here to share her journey with us. We have the amazing Princess Sarah Culberson. Hi, Sarah, and welcome.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me.
We also have a princess with us today.
Let's go. I love it.
I'm very royal.
I must sit up straight. Hello, princess. I love it. Well, first of all, how do you feel when people call you princess? Do you get the jitters, or it's just like, do you own it? I am princess.
I am owning it. Yeah. For a long time, I wouldn't even tell people. I wouldn't talk about it. And now I'm just, because I thought, well, people are going to think, oh, she thinks she's this or that. And I'm like, you know what? This is who I am. I'm just going to own it. So,
yes.
Yeah.
You own it and then you show the rest of us how to own it. That's how we like it.
So can you tell us, going into that, how did you find out that you were a princess? Like, what was your journey? Talk to us.
So one day, this little bird, no, I'm joking. Okay. So
I was like, grandma bird.
It's a dog mother that told you.
What'd you say? I know, right? No. I know. I'm thinking about the Disney movies, right? So actually, we can talk about that later. But actually, I was doing this incredible class called Landmark, and I wanted to have a breakthrough in my acting career at the time. Mm. And what was so interesting is that it wasn't about my acting career. It was actually about having a breakthrough in my life personally. And that was completely a surprise to me. So I was sitting in the class. They said, tell the person sitting next to you where you're holding back in life. And I was sitting next to my friend, Art. I said, listen, Art, you know what? I've never really told anybody this, but I'm really, really afraid of finding my birth father. I'd really like to find him, but I'm afraid. And what's interesting is that I had found my birth mother's family, and my birth mother, unfortunately, had passed away of cancer before I got a chance to meet her. She passed away when I was very young, but I got to see pictures and hear stories and heard that we had the same personality. She loved to sing and dance and act and just, you know, was just wonderful with people, loved people, which is how I am as well. Mm-hmm. And but I said, I want to find my birth father, but I said, what if he doesn't want to meet me? Mm-hmm. And my friend Art said, listen. And I said, also, I don't know how to find him. And Art said, I know a private investigator who won't charge you more than $100 and your birth father is going to love you. Mm-hmm. And I said, okay. I was so scared, but I was like, I'm taking on being loving, open, and courageous.
Love it.
So, and I called the private investigator 3 hours, all the information I needed for $25. It not thousands like I thought it would be.
Right. I would assume that. I'd be like, oh, yeah.
Yeah. Sure. And then I wrote a letter and 4 days later, I got a phone call. I mean, that's how fast it happened. The moment I opened myself up and let go of my fear, everything just showed up. And there was this woman on the other line and she said, hello, Sarah. This is Evelyn. How are you? And I thought, that's a Jamaican woman I met the other day because I couldn't get the accent or the dialect. She said, I'm your auntie. We received your letter. And I started to cry.
This sounds like a movie.
I know.
Wow. Maybe it will be a movie.
Yeah.
Maybe. And she said, she's so sweet. And she said, I was there when you were born. I used to take care of you when your birth mother would go to the grocery store. She said, hold on. Let me get your uncle on the phone. And then my uncle gets on the phone. He goes, oh, Sarah, we are so happy you've been found. Do you know who you are? And I'm like, I'm Sarah. He says, you are part of a royal family. Your great-grandfather was a paramount chief. Your grandfather, you can be chief. You are a princess in this country. And I was literally over. I was like, wait a second. I don't know what to do with this. They said, we're going to contact your father in Sierra Leone. He's going to be so happy to meet you. They contact my father. They get a message from village to village to village because this is 2004. Not everybody has cell phones in Sierra Leone at that time. And then during that time period, I start getting phone calls from all of these different African family members who live in the United States. Hello, Sarah. I'm your Uncle Ali, your father's favorite uncle. Hello, Sarah. I'm your Auntie Jenny. They used to call your father and me twins when we were little. Hello, Sarah. Hello, Sarah. Hello, Sarah. Hello, Sarah. All of these different African family members are welcoming me to the family. When I thought they're not going to want to meet me, they're not going to want to talk to me. And it was this homecoming. And then after the 2 weeks, my father called, my birth father, and I heard his voice for the first time. And the first thing he said to me is he said, please forgive me. I didn't know how to find you after you'd been placed in adoption. Your name had changed. Everything had changed. And I said, no. I'm going to ask you to please forgive me because I've been making you wrong my entire life just to protect myself. And I'm not going to do that anymore.
Sarah, Princess, you got to stop because I feel like we're giving the whole story and there needs to be a movie and a book and everything in between. Gosh. We're going to stop right there. And there probably is all of that in the works. So, yeah.
Yes, there's we have a book. It's called A Princess Found. It's being turned into a movie with Disney. We just sold it. We're in development. We're working on a script right now. We're working on a TV show, a princess TV show. Which
we need to stay tuned for all of the things.
Thank you for all of this. Now, one thing that I know that you're working on, Sarah, is that you're the co-founder of the nonprofit Sierra Leone Rising. So you're working for education, public health, female empowerment in Sierra Leone. So tell us a little bit more. I mean, you've such an incredible story. What does doing this work mean to you? And what is the vision that you have with all of this?
Well, we've been doing this work for the past a little over 15 years. Wow. And the vision is to have clean drinking water for the entire country. Yes. Like just hands down. That's what my brother and I are taking on. Wow. We're going to be meeting with the president of the country this December. And we're going to be setting up a whole plan around what does this look like? And it's a huge task to undertake, but we've been doing that work. We've dug 9 wells that are serving 12,000 people with clean drinking water. We've just sent money this month and we're digging 6 more wells in different areas throughout the provinces that don't have access to clean drinking water. We're doing a sanitary pad project where girls who drop out of school globally due to their menstrual cycle, period poverty really does exist. Mm-hmm. And we have sanitary pads that are reusable, that are washable, that are pretty amazing for girls.
Gosh,
that is amazing,
Princess Sarah. Like, look how the world, look how your world can change with one action.
Absolutely. Right?
Like you have the courage to go, like to go there. You have the courage to find your fault. And look at all of this. Like,
it fell into place. It was like divine.
There is so much we could talk to you about. I mean, truly, I feel like we haven't even scratched the top of the iceberg yet. Let us know, what are you working on next and how can people follow and support everything that you're doing?
Oh my gosh, what are we working on next? If people would love to donate to our work in Sierra Leone, sierraleonerising.org is incredible. Please do that.
Sierraleonerising.org.
Yes, SierraLeoneRising.org. Also, you can check out, you know, be on the lookout in the next couple years for this Disney movie to come out. We're in development now. Get ready for a Roblox game. If you all have children or have nieces and nephews or people who like to play Roblox, we're going to have a game for kids that we're developing. And really, the animation in the movie, these are all the things we're working on. I feel like I wear many hats under this afro somehow. Learning how to balance everything.
A princess's afro, darling.
That's right.
We love all of it. Well, thank you so much for being with us, Princess Sarah. Your story is absolutely incredible. And I know that you're just making such a difference. So we thank you for being here.
Thank you so much. Thanks for having me.
Absolutely. Well, everyone, the show is just heating up and you do not want to miss our next guest. So stay tuned because we'll be right back.